3477.
Welcome back to Get Down to Business. We are chatting with Elliot Cohn, director of Chicago Yachad. And Elliot, you just told us a little bit about the upcoming marathon, which I'm thrilled and honored to be participating in. And once again, you can support that effort, that run, by visiting my website, shalomkline.com. And I've got a link over there to the page. But I'm thrilled to be the co-chair of the Chicago Yachad board here in Chicago. And I keep throwing around the organization name, Elliot, and you talked a little bit about inclusion. We talked a little bit about why people should support the cause. Well, let's drill down into the nitty-gritty details. Tell us a little bit about the work of Yachad and the history in Chicago.
Sure, Shalom. So, it really is a privilege being part of a wonderful organization. I say that knowing it firsthand. Chicago Yachad started about 12 years ago. So it's a part of a larger national organization called Yachad that is centered and headquartered in New York City. And our basic premise is to provide social, recreational, and vocational services to those that are in the community that are differently abled, and making sure that they're able to basically participate in every fabric of life, having a social milieu that they can be a part of, going to recreational activities. And these are people who may have a little bit more of a difficult time reaching out and making friends. And we're there for them. And it's genuine, and it's lifelong. And as they do get older, as they progress through life, we provide vocational services. So we really try to work with the entire family throughout their life.
That's amazing. And as you mentioned, Yachad is part of the part of a national effort. But here in Chicago, it's been just over a decade, I believe.
That's correct. This was at the time really something that did not exist in the community. The fact that people were going out and having a good time and bringing that inclusive component. Now, it's great to do things for all different kinds of people, but the fact that we're able to do it in an inclusive way was much different. And now there are a number of people that are doing this, but we take pride in what we've accomplished and what we provide to the community.
That's fantastic. And so let's talk a little bit about the resources that are made available. You mentioned something which is very important to me, aside for the programs and the fun that is provided to the young adults that are involved in Yachad, although I know that young adults is probably not a fitting description anymore now that there are actually multiple divisions of the organization. But you're involved in helping provide resources to the entire family, but also you're doing something with high schoolers, which I think our listeners would love to hear about. How are you inspiring and promoting inclusion amongst high schoolers that otherwise might not be privy to opportunities and volunteer engagements like this?
So a number of years ago, Shalman, that's a great question. When starting this inclusive component, we needed a peer group. And we have, thankfully, a very wonderful community here in Chicago. And we thought that it would be a great fit for high schoolers to be involved. And as part of this peer group that also participate in the social recreational component. And so we started a board. And what this high school board does is they really become our leaders. It's a high school leadership board. And they help and have a key role in deciding what are the kinds of things that are really cool to do. And they make decisions on how we should do things in our chapter as it pertains to these social or recreational outlets. And they take a key role. And we actually invest in them in other ways by bringing them to national leadership conferences to teach them how can we really become leaders. And so it's this component of helping those that are differently abled, as well as providing mainstream high schoolers with numerous opportunities to grow.
Wait, so Elliot, you just mentioned vocational opportunities, and immediately my ears perked up because this is something that that our listeners can get involved in. Many of our listeners are small business owners. They have places of work. And Elliot, we have our members of Chicago Yachad that are in many employment settings. Are you saying that there's an opportunity for the Chicagoland business community to step up to the plate, to get involved and offer those sort of opportunities to the young adults and adults of Chicago Yachad?
There definitely is, Shalom. I don't know if you're aware, but maybe some of the people in the small business community are aware, but in the special needs population, the unemployment rate is approximately 70 to 80%. Now, that's mind-boggling. And in the underemployment rate is even higher. And we have a number of people with whom we service that
very talented
are looking for
people. Jobs. Very, yeah. Very talented.
Yes. Amazing people. And they're looking for jobs. We want to give them jobs. And it's hard to find them jobs, but we're trying. And we do have a number, as Shalom mentioned, we have a number of people placed. We have a job coach. We support them. This is a fully supported system, and we're looking for more partners, that's for sure.
Wow, fantastic. Well, Elliot, would love to get our listeners in touch with you. As I mentioned, you could always find out more information about the marathon on my website, shalomklein.com. But Yachad is, it's a little tongue twister. It might not be so easy to spell. You gave some websites before. Elliot Cohn, if you don't mind, give us the website one more time, spell it out, and tell us how our listeners can get a hold of you to discuss those vocational opportunities for our members.
Of course. Our website, again, is yachad.org/Chicago. That's yachad.org/Chicago. You can also email me directly at cohene@ou.org, or you can call me directly at 844-4-YACHAD.
Fantastic. YACHAD. We appreciate it. Elliot Cohn, Director of Chicago Yachad, thank you so much for joining us. Support my run on the marathon. Check out my website, shalomklein.com. That's also where you can download podcasts. We'll be right back.
Great.